Hi all, Igor Ekimov is with you. Today we will look at the heating and water supply system pressure tester CT-G0050 from CARTOOL. A pressure tester is a necessary tool for both professional plumbers and home craftsmen to ensure themselves against possible errors when installing heating and water supply. In the previous two videos, I made press connections using manual and hydraulic press jaws. In this video I will perform pressure testing of these connections and check their reliability. I will apply pressure using a pressure tester of 8 to 9 atmospheres. In general, this pressure tester can produce a pressure of up to 50 atmospheres. At the same time, I will tell you how pressure testing of heating and water supply systems occurs, the main stages of pressure testing and why it needs to be done. If you are interested in videos for home DIYers, then subscribe to the channel and press the bell. Special thanks for your likes and reposts. You will find links to the first two videos about press jaws and press connections in the description. The crimper is supplied in such a box. It is supplied unassembled. This is done for convenience and to preserve it during transportation. All hoses and fasteners are located inside. Now I'll get it all out and assemble it. A hose is attached from below, at the end of which there is a filter to clean the liquid that enters the pressure tester. So I assembled a crimping machine. It is held on by four bolts, 1, 2, 3, 4. A hose is connected here, a rubber seal there. There is a 1/2-inch exit here. And the kit includes two spare O-rings in case of servicing the piston system. Here is such a handle for injecting pressure. Next is the pressure gauge. The pressure gauge is supplied with a reserve of up to 60 atmospheres. And here is the pressure relief valve. Since the crimper is a professional, the largest part of the crimper is the 8-liter tank. It itself is made of fairly thick steel. There are handles that make it convenient to carry the crimping machine. To use it, just fill it with water and connect this hose to the system. Here we already have a section of water supply or heating, which we collected in the last two videos. To check it, you need to apply a pressure greater than the nominal pressure in the system. The nominal pressure in the heating system is 2 atmospheres. In the hot water supply system, 4.5 atmospheres. In the cold water supply system, it can reach 6 atmospheres. Typically, pressure testing is done with a pressure of 1.5 to 2 times greater than the nominal pressure, but no more than the weakest element of the system. Our maximum pressure that pipes can withstand is 10 atmospheres. So I will give a pressure of 8 to 9 atmospheres. Pressure testing is a hydraulic test of the system. Pressure testing is usually done after rough installation, before finishing the room. With the help of pressure testing, we make sure that our system is reliable and that all pipes and connections can withstand increased pressure. I will do pressure testing with cold water. Pressure testing with water is more popular than pressure testing with air because it is faster, since water is not compressible. Cold water is used so that there is no error due to a decrease in pressure when the system cools. However, the pressure tester can withstand temperatures up to 120 degrees. If you need to do a pressure test at the rated coolant temperature, the pressure tester has a 60 atmosphere pressure gauge. This is with a small margin to the maximum operating pressure of this press machine. But we installed an additional 16 bar pressure gauge in the system in order to see the pressure in the system when the pressure tester is turned off. After pressure testing, we leave the system under pressure approximately equal to the nominal one. We have a 16 atmosphere pressure gauge. This allows you to measure pressure more accurately than with a pressure gauge on a 60 atmosphere press machine. After we build up the pressure, close the shut-off valve and we can turn off the pressure tester. Also, at the other end, we have a Mayevsky crane in order to expel air from the system. All I have to do is connect this mini system to the press machine, and I can build up the pressure. As you can see, I connected my system to the crimping machine. To connect the presser to the system, a reinforced hose with a connecting size of 1/2 inch is used. I sealed the joint with flax and paste. First, we need to fill our system with water. It is possible to fill the system directly from the water supply. But if you use special prepared distilled water or antifreeze, then it is better to use Brook-type pumps. Since my system volume is minimal, I will fill it with the help of a pressure tester. In one stroke of the piston, the system is filled with 50 milliliters. Before filling the system, close the pressure relief valve and open the valve supplying water to the system. And open the Mayevsky valve. And we download. Water started flowing from my Mayevsky tap, so I turned it off. Now I'll turn up the pressure. My press connections are not leaking. But the connections that I made with flax and paste began to flow. I'll fix it now. Eliminating a leak during pressure testing is a completely workable case. If you are making a system for a customer, then I suggest breaking the crimping process into two stages. At the first stage, you check the tightness of the system for yourself, eliminating all possible leaks. And in the second stage, you demonstrate the tightness of the system for the customer. At the same time, show how to work with a pressure gauge, so that he can monitor it during finishing work. So I reached the pressure to 10 atmospheres. As you can see, there are no leaks anywhere. I had a leak here where I used flax and paste. I wound more flax and I no longer have any leaks here. Usually the pressure is checked for 5 minutes, and then the nominal pressure is left. When crimping pipes made of metal plastic or PEX pipes, it must be taken into account that the pipes expand during crimping, and therefore pressure must be added after 5 minutes. I added more pressure to 10 atmospheres. Let's see if the pressure drops with the tap closed. 5 minutes have passed. As you can see, the pressure has not dropped. The pipes no longer expand. We can check again to see if there are any leaks. There are no leaks here. There are no leaks here either. There are no leaks here either. We opened the tap. Opened the tap here. So I relieved the pressure using this valve. Left the pressure at 3 atmospheres and closed the shut-off valve. Now we can turn off the pressure tester and our system will be under pressure. Thus, we verified that our system is airtight. If someone damages a pipe during construction work after us, the pressure gauge will show this. That is, the pressure gauge is an indicator that the finishing work is progressing normally. And the pipe and all connections are not damaged. If you are a plumber, then show this pressure gauge. And invite the owner to follow its arrow during finishing work. If the pressure suddenly drops, it means that the system has been damaged somewhere. And the problem needs to be corrected before the finishing work is completed. When performing pressure testing, a plumber insures himself against possible claims from the customer. When leaving, he pressurized the system, left it under pressure, which means he made it airtight. If depressurization occurs, then, most likely, those specialists who are currently working at the site are to blame. With this pressure tester, you can check heating batteries immediately after purchase. It is no secret that heating batteries are often purchased in advance. And you can check them without waiting for their warranty to expire. They can also check other elements of the water supply or heating, such as heat exchangers. So I put the crimping machine back together. Still, it takes up less space this way and is more convenient to transport. I put all the adapters and hoses in the tank. You can also put other adapters here that will appear during the work. These two handles make it easy to carry. The system remained disconnected, with the tap turned off, and we still had a pressure of 3 atmospheres. I'll leave this system pressurized and see how long it lasts. Leave your questions about this crimping tool in the comments. If you have experience in pressure testing water supply, heating systems and individual system elements, share it in the comments. I think this will be useful to other viewers of the channel. Share the video with those who are interested in this topic. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss new videos. Like, and see you in new and old videos.